This video has been made possible by Skillshare, a great place to start learning any creative skill you like. I'm sure you saw Apple's Vision Pro headset being announced a couple of months ago. Now, what if I told you that you can convert any of your Figma prototypes and UI designs into a live 3D spatial VR experience, just like you saw in the trailer? Let me introduce you to something called Bezel. Now, Bezel is a platform that allows you to go from Figma to spatial UI design, and it does it seamlessly with a lot of cool features that I'm going to show you today. Now, to start off, log in into Bezel and you'll find this nice little page right here. You can always learn from the tutorial. For now, I just pull up new files. Great thing is that it asks you whether you need an AR scene, a 3D scene, or a VR scene. All three are somewhat different, so pick the right one. We're going to go with VR for now, and it applies a cool template for us. This is us standing here. Now, I want to bring in a Figma file. Any UI that I've designed can be imported into this in a jiffy. For example, I have this Vision OS UI kit from Apple. I'll have a link in the description. This, it's super simple. I'll go to this Figma icon on the top left, and under Help and Account, there's something called Account Settings. If I open this, there's a little pop-up that opens up. At the bottom, you'll find personal access tokens. And you need to just generate a new token. You can name it anything. I'm going to name it Bezel, just so that I remember. And an expiration, you can set to 30 days, 90 days, or no expiration. Everything else can stay as it is. Generate a token. And this generates a unique token called Bezel. Under Bezel, you can just copy this token quick. Head over to my Bezel file right here. Right under material, I have standard material. I'll click on it, it'll open this pop-up. And right next to the color, there is this blank square. Click on this square. And once you get this image on top, there will also be an option under this called Figma. And it asks for the Figma token. I'll paste my Figma token and I'll say save changes. And I'm going to copy over whichever frame I have here. I'm going to right click. And under this menu, there's something called copy paste as. I'm going to hover over and say copy link, and that's all you need to do. And inside this Figma frame, you can paste the link at any point of time and press enter. As it says here, syncing Figma file. In a second, you will have this menu that we had in Figma, and you can of course move it around till it's actually visible on screen like this. So you'll be able to see whatever this person is seeing just like this, seamless. Want to just quickly test it out. There's a play button on the top right. It will open a prototype of sorts. As you can see, this is what the person would be able to see. This is what your user will be able to see, and you can actually rotate it, zoom out as per your preference. Now, this video has been brought to you by Skillshare. You can get Skillshare for free if you watch till the end of this segment. Skillshare is a perfect online platform to find and learn creative skills that you've been wanting to learn for months now. For example, my favorite one was MKBHD's class. I've taken it from the beginning till the end and I was super stoked about it. He teaches everything about video editing, processing, shooting, etc. One of my favorite things about Skillshare is that you can create learning paths and an entire playlist for yourself of sorts. And inside my learning paths, you'll be able to discover hundreds, if not thousands, of different learning paths for yourself. For example, this Master Your Productivity with Ali Abdal is just a perfect example of that. You can quickly go ahead and save it. You'll find Ali Abdal's learning path right here. So you go from one step to the other and it creates a path for you of sorts. There are relevant categories for everything. UX design, which we love, photography, illustrations, graphic designs, video editing, animation. Under UI UX, you can find a lot of subcategories. Now, a lot of you asked me about freelancing and entrepreneurship. So freelancing and entrepreneurship is an actual category with a lot of subcategories. The first 1,000 people, you can use the link in my description to get 1 month of Skillshare absolutely free. No strings attached. So go ahead, click on the link in the description, head over to Skillshare, create your account, and start learning from these amazing courses, which you're getting essentially for free. It has all the 3D capabilities you'll find in a 3D tool like Spline as well. So you can create these 3D objects from the menu on top, everything from sphere to humans to box. You can create. You can even import 3D models. So even a complex car you can bring in and then create VR experiences with that car. You can select any one of these, change the material, which I really like. You can increase or decrease the roughness. You can add properties such as metalness as well as opacity to this as well. If you want this to look like as if it's metal, you can make it look like metal as well. But something cool that they are introducing is asset library. So instead of going to some other website, getting 3D models, you can have everything that you want here in their library. So they have a bed, a door, a couch. Comments is something we all like in Figma, and comments are here as well. As you can see, the team has already placed some comments here. You can place your own comments by clicking anywhere and typing in whatever you like. This can be edited later. You can even draw comments. So if you want a circle, you can circle, and it will stay in this 3D environment. And collaboration is here as well. Yes, Bezel has a collaborative space. Just like in Figma, people join in your file, make edits, work together. They have all those features here as well. You just have to copy the link of the file, send it to your person, send it to your team, and they can all join with free will. They have something called a gallery, which I'm glad they do, because for a beginner like me, it's difficult to create experiences. Hey Punit, what if you want to create an animation? Animations are actually simpler than they look. For example, if I hover on this couch right here, it should start hovering or flying in the air. On the right, I have something called states. States are what you can switch between at any point of time. So base state looks like this. State number two might look like it's flying in the air. So I can bring it up like this. And on the top, there is something called this lightning bolt. I can use this lightning bolt to go from one state to the other by hovering or whatever I like. It should start from the base state, which is perfect. And from base state, I can always take you to state one. This could be pointer down or hover inside, which is perfect. And you can even set the animation curve. In and out is fine. Now, if you play it in your VR headset as well, when you are looking at this, the couch starts to float. I hope you guys like this video. If you did, make sure you hit the thumbs up, share this with anyone who's interested, and subscribe for such videos every single week. I'll see you next time, same place, same time. Until next time, take care. God bless.